Okay, so today we're going to cover basic layouts in Flutter. These are the main ones we're going to cover. There might be some other ones that show up in the code, but that's what we're going to go with for now. I'm going to go over each one a little bit on OneNote, and then we can get into the actual code of it later. So center. Let's pretend we have an app. Center takes whatever open space is left and puts everything in the middle. So if we have the whole screen, hello, a text would go right in the middle. Pretty simple. Container is just used to contain something. So if you just have a hello, it won't look any different than your normal text. But what you could do with the container is you could add padding. So you could have this hello have an offset of something in the middle. You can have it have margins. You could have it have borders, even. You could have it have a background color. It's just something to contain all the widgets and be like a base for the widgets that are lower in the tree. Next one is rows. Rows and columns are pretty simple. When you create a row, just have a row, right? When you create a column, if it's inside that row, you have a column. You can nest rows and columns as much as you want. Inside that column, you can have more rows. And it's probably one of the easier layouts and that I use often. It's very, very basic and very powerful. Next one is expanded. So expanded, you can think of it's going to take up as much room as you can while not overflowing to the edges. So let's say you have an image here in this row, right? You have a picture here, and then you have text that overruns here. If you put the text in an expanded widget, so put this in an expanded, this part that's getting cut off will be put in the line under. Same with images. So let's say you have a row, you have an image here, and you have a long image here. If you put this image in an expanded widget, this image will be shrunk and you'll have a smaller picture overall, but it will fit within the view. List view is pretty simple. It's basically just rows of lists. So let's say you have a list view with just text in it. You'll just see hey, hello, in a list. And stack is the one I haven't used as much, but it is also pretty simple. So you can put it's basically just same thing as the stack we talked about in the navigation video. It's just you can put things on top of each other, right? So let's say you have an image here, a nice little guy chilling, and then you can put text over it. Very simple. But okay, let's get into the code of it and how it looks in Flutter actually. Okay, so here we have a base Flutter app with absolutely nothing in it. We have the actual screen and a stateful widget, and we have the app. So in Flutter, everything is a widget except for this one line right here that says run app, and then you define your root widget here of what app you want it to run. And then from there on, everything else is a widget. Here we have a screen called Home, and let's just get right into it. So the first one was called Center. Center is, like I said, just puts everything in the middle. You notice the text here is red and underlined. That means there's no base to where to put that text on. What does that mean? It means you need a scaffold. So a scaffold is pretty much like a base of where your app rests on. You can't just have a typing and talking too fast. You have to have something that the app resides on, like a base where you could put all your widgets on. Just like in building a house or whatever, you need scaffolding. Same thing with the app. So now you see the text looks a lot better in the center. And we can turn on this thing called, this is very useful, debug painting. You'll notice you get on the app, you'll get all these lines that tell you exactly what it's doing. So the hello is this big and it's centered across the whole screen. We can also add a thing called an app bar. So the app bar is like it sounds. It's a bar of the app at the top. It shows up just like that. You can also hover over the app bar or any widget if you're using VS Code, probably some other IDE too, probably Android Studio, I'm not sure. But it'll show you all the options that you could use. For example, there's leading widget. You can have actions, which are widgets that come over here. And you can do things like center title, set that to true, and it'll center the title. Just hover over, look through all the options that the widget has, and that should help you lay out your app just how you want. Center doesn't have that many options. It just pretty much centers whatever widget you put inside. A more powerful one, well, I guess, I don't know if it's more powerful or not, but a container. So with a container, you could do a lot of other things. So you notice it doesn't seem like there's anything different. If you remove this container, you would still see the same thing. But you, for a container, you could add padding. Now you have padding around the whole container. You could add a background color or just color. Colors.green. And you could have a background color now. It doesn't look as nice, doesn't look as green as because we have the debug painter on, but if you turned off the debug painter, what did I just do? Okay, so you can see it's actually green. Now, if we turn the debug painter back on, you can see the layout's better. That's pretty much containers. It could do a lot of other things. Decorations, borders, constraints, heights, width, things like that. But also we have these things called rows. So rows and columns are probably one of the more powerful layout tools that are used throughout any type of app development. And they're very simple. It's just rows and columns. Just like anywhere. So if we add text 1, 2, 3, you'll see we get a row of 1, 2, and 3. You can add properties like main axis alignment, space evenly, and it'll space out your widgets however you want. Columns are very similar things. If we wrap the row in a column, we'll see nothing changes. We just have one column. But now we can add another row inside that column. We could do the same thing, 1, 2, 3. Now we have two rows of 1, 2, 3. This one's not spaced evenly. But we could also add things like images. So image.asset, images / what that named them, lake.jpg, I think. Let's see if that works. Yes. These images, you have to save them somewhere in this repository and then add them to your pubspec.yaml. So now you see we have a problem here. It overflows. The easiest way to fix it is to wrap this widget in a thing called expanded. Like I told you before, expanded means it takes up the maximum amount of space while still showing all your things. So see the picture, the 2 and the 3 are also in there. And let's say we add the other two images. We had person.jpg and tree.jpg. Notice they all fit. So there's this thing called flex with extended. Flex is pretty much ratios of how the three things that are expanded fit within the screen. So before it's 1 to 1 to 1. And now if we set the middle one to 3, it's going to be 1 to 3 to 1. If we save that, you'll see this becomes a lot bigger, but everything still fits within the screen. So last one, not last one, I guess, second to last one is list view. This view is pretty straightforward as well. You can have text or whatever widgets you want in a list view, and they will show up like lists. Like a vertical list of things. Just like that. You have these things called list tiles, which have titles, list tile. You can have, I think, leading. You can put an icon. Like an alarm. I'll have a nice list tile with an icon in there. You have things like subtitle. That's what it looks like. And it's getting kind of hard to see. Title debug painting. That's what a list tile looks like. These other things on a list. Pretty simple. And then the last thing is a stack. Also, you can make sure you hover over list view. You can see all these other things you can do. You can control, have a scroll controller where it tells you where your scroller is and do things depending on where your scroller is. All these things. Stack is like I described on the OneNote, stack things on top of each other. If we have image, we'll see an image. And then we want to stack, for example, an icon on top of it. Is there a tree icon? No. Let's just say texture. You cannot see that very well, but it's there. Let's change its color. There. Wrap this in an expanded widget. That doesn't work. Do not wrap icons in expanded widgets. Okay, so do not use an expanded widget inside a stack. Learn something new every day. But you could change things like size. You could change it to whatever, 30. 300. Now you have a big overlay. So that's pretty much it on layouts. That's all the basics. This code will be on GitHub in the description if you want. If you have any questions about layouts or anything like that, make sure to leave it in the comments. Also, if you enjoyed the video, please make sure to like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.